Dear students, welcome to another session of eShikshana Program 3. In my last lecture, I discussed about the probability and also solved some interesting problems on basic probability. The next chapter in the syllabus is random variables. So first of all, let us understand what is the sample space here. The set of all distinct events or outcomes for a random experiment is called the sample space provided two or more of these outcomes do not occur simultaneously. Each random experiment is resulting into exactly one of the outcomes. For example, consider the experiment of tossing two coins. The four possible outcomes, distinct outcomes, are the following: head, 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 tail, tail, head, and tail, tail. So, therefore, the sample space, usually denoted by capital letter S, is equal to HH, HT, TH, TT. Random variables. A random variable is a function from the sample space S into set of real numbers R. Random variables are denoted by capital letters capital X, capital Y, capital Z, etc. So let us understand how this random variable creates a function from sample space S into set of real numbers R. Suppose we toss three coins, or a coin is tossed three times. The corresponding sample space is, in this experiment, eight distinct outcomes are possible. So namely, all heads H, 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 T. H stands for head, T stands for tail, H, T, H, T, H, 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 T, 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 H, T, 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 H, T, 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 no heads, here no tails, and the other combination, head and tail, are mixed. So now, let us define a random variable X as the number of heads. So number of heads here, 3, number of heads here, 2, number of heads here, 2, and again here, 2, number of heads 1, 1, 1, and no heads. So X can take the values 0, 0 heads, 1 head, 2 heads, and 3 heads. So X can take the values 0, 1, 2, 3. So thus X varies over the set A 0, 1, 2, 3. This can be regarded as a subset of a real number system R. Now consider the sample space S. Yes, this is the sample space with the sample points H, 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 that is 3 heads, H, H, T, 2 heads, 1 tail, H, T, H, 2 heads, 1 tail, T, H, H, 2 heads, 1 tail, H, T, T, 1 head, 2 tails, T, H, T, 1 head, 2 tails, T, T, H, 1 head, 2 tails, and T, 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 no heads at all. So now, this random variable X creates association from S into set A, which is a subset of R, like this. So 3 heads is associated, X associates this 3 heads to numerical value 3 in the set A, and 2 heads to the numerical value 2 in the set A. Again, another 2 heads, another sample point with the 2 heads to numerical value 2 in the set A. Similarly, another sample point with the 2 heads, X associates this sample point with numerical value 2 in the set A. Similarly, X associates 1 head, there are 3 cases here, and all of them to the numerical value 1 in the set A, and no heads, that is X is equal to 0, no heads, that is T, 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 x is equal to 0 to the no heads to the numerical value 0 in the set A, which is a subset of set of real numbers R. So this shows that x creates an association from the sample space S into a sample space into a set A, which happens to be a subset of the set of real numbers. This shows that random variable x is a function from S into R. Thus, the random variable x is a function from sample space S into a set of real numbers R. There are two types of random variables: discrete random variable and continuous random variable. A random variable x that can take at most countable number of possible values is said to be discrete. For example, the number of heads in 4 tosses of a coin is a discrete random variable, as it cannot take value other than 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. A random variable x that can take any value between some intervals is called a continuous random variable. So RV stands for random variable. So for example, the height of a group of students, weight of group of students, ages of group of people in a town, these are all the examples of continuous random variable. Now, probability mass function, PMF. This is defined for the discrete random variable. If x is a discrete random variable RV, which assumes values x1, x2, x3, xn with probability p of x1, p of x2, p of xn respectively, then p is called the probability mass function, PMF of x, provided the following two conditions are satisfied. 1. P of xi is greater than or equal to 0 for all I is equal to 1 to n, and sigma of pxi is equal to 1. That means sum of the probabilities is equal to 1. Probability density function, PDF. If x is a continuous random variable, then a function f, small f, is said to be probability density function, PDF, of the continuous random variable x if it satisfies following conditions. 1. F of x is greater than or equal to 0 for all x, and integral from minus to plus infinity of f of x dx is equal to 1. So in practice, if there is any probability of some finite values a and b, probability of a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b, then we immediately write integral from a to b f of x dx, where a and b are the values between minus infinity and plus infinity. Cumulative distribution function, CDF, cumulative distribution function. Let x be a random variable, discrete or continuous. We define capital F to be the cumulative distribution function, or CDF, of the random variable capital X if f of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to x, small x, and 1. P of x less than or equal to x, so this is defined for discrete and continuous separately, where P of x less than or equal to x is equal to sigma summation from I from 0 to x of pxi. If x is a discrete random variable, where for a continuous random variable, P of x less than or equal to x is equal to integral from minus infinity to plus minus infinity to x of f of x dx if x is a continuous random variable. expectation. Let x be a random variable, continuous or discrete. The expected value of x denoted by e of x is defined as e of x is equal to sigma x into px. If x is discrete random variable, e of x is equal to integral from minus infinity to plus infinity x into f of x dx if x is continuous random variable. Other names for expectation are mean, average, expected value, etc. Variance. Sigma square is equal to sigma of summation of x minus e of x whole square into px if x is discrete random variable. Variance for a continuous random variable, sigma square is equal to integral from minus infinity to plus infinity x minus e of x whole square f of x dx if x is a continuous random variable. Standard deviation is the square root of variance. So variance is calculated. Variance, these two are calculated using this simple formula. Sigma square, that is variance, is equal to ex square minus e of x the whole square. So this is the mean. E of x is the mean or average. So this proof is very simple. So sigma square is equal to summation x minus e of x whole square px. This is for a discrete random variable. Similarly, we can obtain this formula for a continuous random variable as well. So now we expand this as a minus b whole square formula. So summation of x square minus twice ex into x plus e of x the whole square multiplied by p of x. Remember, ex is a average, so it is a numerical value, so constant. So now let us multiply these three quantities terms by px and separate into three summations. So sigma x square into px one summation minus 2 is constant, e of x is also constant, so nothing to do with the summation. So twice e of x into sigma x into px, so sigma x into px plus e of x is again a mean. These two are numerical values. It is squared. It is again a numerical value. So it has nothing to do with the summation. So as it can write this quantity as well outside the summation. So e of x whole square into sigma px. So this is equal to sigma x square into px minus twice e of x, and this is nothing but our e of x only, average or mean. So e of x into e of x makes e of x whole square plus sigma e of x whole square into 1, that is sum of the probabilities sigma px is equal to 1, is one of the condition of probability mass function for a discrete random variable x, capital X. So this can be written as e of x is sigma x px. So this x, if there is x, capital X will come here. If there is x square, capital X square. If there is x power n, e of x power n. So here we have x square. So e of x square minus 2 e of x the whole square plus e of x the whole square. That makes it to minus e of x the whole square. So the formula for calculation of variance, usually we consider this formula, very easy to use. Sigma square is variance. Sigma square is equal to e of x square minus e x the whole square. So you can easily remember sigma square variance is equal to e x square minus e x the whole square. Similarly, sigma square variance for a continuous random variable can be derived as sigma square is equal to E x square minus E of x the whole square for a continuous random variable capital X. So in both the cases, standard deviation is the root of variance. Let us consider the problem. Problem number one. Suppose a random variable capital X has the following distribution. X taking the value 2, 4, 6 and 8. The corresponding probabilities P of 2 is 0.1, P of 4 is 0.2, P of 6 is 0.3, P of 8 is 0.4. Compute the mean and the standard deviation of X. The compute the mean. The mean is E of X, and we have the definition for that. And standard deviation of X. So standard deviation comes from variance. First we have to find the variance, and the square root of variance is the standard deviation. So let me do this problem in one of the slides. I'll create a space to work out this problem here, and similarly other problems can be worked out. Now look at the problem. Suppose a random variable X has the following distribution. So we need to compute mean and standard deviation of X. So mean E of X X is equal to sigma X into P of X. What is this P of X into P of X? This is small x is x1, x2, x3, x4. So px1 into px1 plus x2 into px2 plus x3 into px3 plus x4 into px4. So that's what it means. So now 2 into 0.1, 4 into 0.2, 2 into 0.1 plus 4 into 0.2 plus 6 into 0.3 plus 8 into 0.4. So this is our mean E of X. E of X. X into sigma, summation of X into Px. So that is So this Px, if you calculate this, you get 6. So mean of this distribution is 6. So mean is 6. Similarly, variance. Variance is equal to E of x square minus ex the whole square. E of the x whole square, that is mean x, mean square, that is 6 square. So first we shall calculate what is E of x square. So E of x square is equal to sigma x square px. Sigma x square px. So this is equal to 2 square into 0.1 2 square into 0.1 0.1 plus 4 square into 0.2 plus 6 square into 0.3 plus 8 square into 0.4. So when you calculate this will be equal to 40. So variance, sigma x square px is 40, but our variance sigma square is equal to ex square is 40 minus ex the whole square, that is 36 into 36, so 36 square. So this is this is equal to 4. So standard deviation is square root of variance, that is square root of 4 is equal to 2. standard deviation. Standard deviation. It is taking some time. So standard deviation is equal to root of 4 is 2. Standard deviation is 2. So I will cancel out this worksheet. So the solution in detail for that particular problem is given here. So now with the help of this workout, I think other problems can be easily done. But problem number 2. A random variable x has the following distribution. X takes the values minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and corresponding probabilities P of minus 2, 0.1, P of minus 1, K, P of 0, 0.2, P of 1, 2K, P of 2, 0.3, P of 3, K. Find the value of K, mean and the variance of X. So in this problem, we have to find the value of K as well mean of the distribution and also variance of the random variable X. Now this, the value of K comes from sum of the probability is equal to 1. So we know that sigma Px is equal to 1. So sigma Px is sum of these values 0.1 plus K plus 0.2 plus 2K plus 0.3 plus K, that makes sigma Px. That should be equal to 1 because sum of the probability is equal to 1. So this makes 0.1 plus 0.2 plus 0.3, that makes 0.6 plus K plus 2K plus K, 3 plus 1, 4K is equal to 1. So 4K is equal to 1 minus 0.6. This is equal to 0.4. Therefore, value of K is 0.4 divided by 4, that makes 0.1. So therefore, K is equal to 0.1. So now, let us consider the next question, the mean of the random variable capital X, that is given by E of X is equal to sigma X into Px. So this is how the previous problem was done. So what we have to do here, sigma x px, this into this, plus 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 this into this. So sigma x into px, so minus 2 into 0.1, plus minus 1 into k, plus 0 into 0.2, plus 1 into 2k, plus 2 into 0.3, plus 3 into k. So that makes 0.4 and plus 4k. So k value is already calculated, it is 0.1. So 0.4 plus 4 into 0.1 is equal to 0.4 plus 0.4 is equal to 0.8. So mean of the random variable capital X, or mean of the distribution, is E of X is equal to 0.8. Now variance. Variance definition is sigma square is equal to E x square minus E of x the whole square. So E of x is already calculated. E of x is 0.8. So now we need to calculate only E of x square. So E of x square is nothing but summation x square into px. So x square, x values, you square the x values multiplied by px, and the summation will be like this. Minus 2 whole square, that is the value of x, minus 2 square, corresponding probability is 0.1. So minus 2 square 0.1 plus minus 1 square k plus 0 square 0.2 plus 1 square 2k plus 2 square 0.3 plus 3 square k. So this is equal to, if you simplify, add the similar terms, you get 12k plus 1.6 is equal to 2.8, because the value of k is 0.1. So variance sigma square is E of x square minus E of x the whole square. E of x square is 2.8 minus E of x is 0.8. E of x is 0.8. So 0.8 square, so that makes into 2.16. So variance is 2.16, a mean is 0.8, the standard deviation is square root of variance. So variance is 2.16, so root of 2.16, that will be 1.4696. Problem number 3. A random variable capital X has the following probability function. X takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Corresponding probabilities P of 0, 0, P of 1, K, P of 2, 2K, P of 3, 2K, P of 4, 3K, P of 5, K square, P of 6, 2 into k square, P of 7, 7 k square plus k. Find the value of k. The question is, find 1, the value of k, 2, P of x less than 6, 3, P of x greater than or equal to 6, and problem number 4, find the minimum value of x so that P of x less than or equal to small x is greater than 1 by 2 or 0.5. So we need to find this numerical value for which this inequality is valid. Now finding the value of k, as in the previous case problem, that comes from one of the conditions of PMF, sigma px is equal to 1, that is sum of the probabilities is equal to 1. So we know that sigma px is equal to 1. So sigma px is sum of these probabilities 0 plus k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k plus k square plus 2k square plus 7k square plus k. So sigma px is equal to 1. That means the sum of the probabilities, whatever is given in the problem, should be equal to 1, that is 0 plus k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k plus k square plus 2k square plus 7k square plus k is equal to 1. So if you simplify this, this will reduce to 10k square plus 9k is equal to 1, or 10k square plus 9k minus 1 equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation which can be factorized and solved, which can be solved for k. So when if we can factorize this, so this will be, if we factorize, this will be a product of two factors, 10k minus 1 into k plus 1 equal to 0. Now this means k is equal to 1 by 10 or k is equal to minus 1. So these values satisfy this equation. Are solving this, we get k is equal to 1 by 10, k is equal to minus 1. So out of these two values, one of the values should be the correct one. Another one is cannot be considered. For example, this k is equal to minus 1 cannot be considered, because when k is minus 1, probability becomes negative. Probability becomes negative. But probability is always a positive, lying between 0 and 1, inclusive of 0 and 1. So the consideration of this value is overruled. That means we have to consider the positive value k, which is equal to 1 by 10. So therefore, the required value of k is 1 by 10 or 0.1. Second problem, probability of x less than 6, and this is written as, or this is nothing but the sum of probabilities less than 6. That means p of 0 starting from 0, p of 1 plus p of 2 plus p of 3 plus p of 4 plus p of 5, because it is discrete, so there cannot be any other value less than 6 except 5. So now write the values of corresponding probabilities. P of 0 is 0, so this you can easily notice here. P of 0 is 0. P of 1 is k, so P of 1 is k. P of 2 is 2k, so P of 2 is 2k. P of 3 is 2k, so P of 3 is again 2k. P of 4 is 3k, so P of 4 is 3k. P of 5 is k squared. P of 5 is k squared. So 0 plus k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k plus k squared. So this will reduce to 8k plus k squared. So 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 3, 8, 8k, and k squared alone. 8k plus k squared. So k value is 1 by 10. So 8 by 10 plus 1 by 10 squared, that is 1 by 100. So this is 80 plus 1, 81 by 100. 0.81. So probability of x less than 6 is 0.81. Similarly, the next question, p of probability of x greater than or equal to 6. So this makes the last one is 7 only. So inclusive of 6, greater than or equal to 6. So p of 6 plus p of 7. So p of 6 is 2k squared, so this we can easily make out. P of 6 is 2k squared. P of 7 is 7k squared plus k. So P of 6 is 2 squared. P of 7, 7k squared plus k. So this reduces to 9k squared plus k. So k value is 1 by 10. So 9 by 100 plus k, 1 by 10. So this makes into 19. 9 plus 10, 19. Divided by 100, so that is 0.19. The last question, find the minimum value of x so that p of x less than or equal to x is greater than 0.5. So we need to find the value of x for which this inequality is balanced. So let us go by a trial and error method. Let us consider first the value of x is equal to 2 and check whether this point is this value is greater than 0.5 or not, and stop when that particular value comes. P of x less than or equal to 2 is starting from 0 to 2. P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2. P of 0 is 0. P of 1 is k. P of 2 is 2k, so 0 plus k plus 2k, that makes 3k. So 3 divided by 10, because k is 1 by 10, so 3 by 10 is 0.3. So this is a value less than 0.5. So let us check with next value, 3. P of x less than or equal to 3 is written as P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3. So P of 0 to P of 2, we know the value less than or equal to 2, we know the value 0.3. So I can directly substitute from P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 is equal to 0.3 plus P of 2 is 2k, p of 2 is 2k, so p of 2 is 2k, so k is 0.1, that is 1 by 10, so this makes 0.5, so this is exactly equal to but not greater than 0.5. so let us try with next value. X is equal to 4. Now this can be written as p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2 plus p of 3 plus p of 4. So from p of 0 to p of 3 is 0.5. So from here to here 0.5 plus p of 4. P of 4 is 3k. P of 4 is 3k. So p of 4 is 3k. K is 0.1 or 1 by 10. So this makes into 0.5 plus 3 by 10 is equal to 0.8, which is greater than 0.5. So this is the value for which p of x less than or equal to x is greater than 0.5. So minimum value of x for which p of x less than or equal to small x greater than 0.5 is small x is equal to 4. Next problem. The probability distribution of a random variable x is capital X, which takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The corresponding probabilities p of 0 is k, p of 1 is 3k, p of 2 is 5k, p of 3 is 7k, p of 4 is 9k, p of 5 11k, p of 6 13k. Find the value of k and find p of x less than 4, p of x greater than or equal to 5, p of 3 less than, strictly less than capital X, less than or equal to 6. The value of k, we know how to find this. This comes from the sum of the probabilities is equal to 1. So this we have done in the previous two problems. So first let us find the value of k. We know that sigma px is equal to 1. So therefore, sum of the probabilities k plus 3k plus 5k plus 7k plus 9k plus 11k plus 13k should be equal to 1. So that is what is written here. Therefore, k plus 3k plus 5k plus 7k plus 9k plus 11k plus 13k is equal to 1. So when we sum all this, we get 49k is equal to 1. Therefore, k is 1 by 49. P of less than 4 is written as, less than 4 means we have to stop at 3. P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3. So this is equal to k, corresponding probabilities. You can check with this. P of 0 is k, 1 is 3k, 2 is 5k, 3 is 7k. K plus 3k plus 5k plus 7k. So this comes to 16k. So k is 1 by 49. So therefore 16 by 49 is the probability of x less than 4. Next, probability of x greater than or equal to 5. So this is written as p of 5 plus p of 6. So there are only two, greater than or equal to 5. So including 5, there are only two, 5 and 6 x value. So p of 5 plus p of 6, this is equal to, so p of 5 is 11k, p of 6 is 13k. So 11k plus 13k, that comes to 24k. The value of k is 1 by 49, that is equal to 24 by 49. Next, probability of 3 less than x less than or equal to 6. So this is equal to, so strictly less than 3, so 3 cannot be included. The next value of x is 4, so start from 4, p of 4 plus p of 5. So at stop at 6, p of 6. So p of 4 is 9k, that you can easily see here. P of 4 is 9k, 5 is 11k, 6 is 13k. So 9k plus 11k plus 13k. So this is equal to 20 plus 13, 33k. So that makes the value of k is 1 by 49. So p of 3 strictly less than x less than or equal to 6 is 33 by 49. Okay, so this is a good problem. A die is tossed thrice. A success is getting 1 or 6 on a toss. Find the mean and variance of the number of successes. So here the random variable, a discrete random variable, is number of successes. A die is tossed thrice. A success is getting 1 or 6. If 1 comes, it is a success. Or 6, one of the faces, 6 means number 6 written on one of the faces of a die is 6. So that means there is an equal probability for all the faces to come. So the probability of getting success 1 for a success is 1 by 6, and probability of success, that is for getting 6, again it is not a numerical value 6, it is the face where number is written 6. So probability of that particular event is also 1 by 6. So probability of success is 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. That makes into 2 by 6, that is 1 by 3. Okay. Now, a die is tossed thrice. So number of successes can be 0. So no success at all. No success at all. That means none of these faces will turn up. Or there can be a one success that can appear in different ways, like first toss success, second failure, third failure, or first failure, second success, third failure, or first two failure, third success, or it can be two. The random variable can be two also, that is two successes that also can come in this forum. First two successes, third one failure. First success, second failure, third success. Or it can be first failure and second and third success. So it can assume the value 3, where all the cases are success. So that is also possible. So x is the random variable which counts the number of successes, can take the values at most 0, no success, 1, 1 success, 2, 2 success, and 3 successes. First, let us find out the distribution of this random variable, number of successes of this particular experiment. So let x be the random variable denoting number of successes. Clearly, x can take the values 0, 1, 2, 3. So probability of a success as per the given definition P is equal to 1 by 6 for getting the face 1 or getting the face 6. That is also its probability is also 1 by 6. So 1 or 6 is 1 by 6, its probability 1 by 6 plus probability another 1 by 6 that is 2 by 6, that is equal to 1 by 3. So probability of a success is 1 by 3. So its complement is a failure. So probability of a failure Q is equal to 1 minus P is 2 by 3. So let us consider P for a success and small q for a failure. Okay. What is the probability of X is equal to 0? That is no successes. That means the first case also failure, second case failure, third case failure. These are all independent events. So this can be written as probability of Q into probability of Q into probability of Q. So probability of Q is 2 by 3 into 2 by 3 again into 2 by 3. So that is equal to 8 by 27. So probability of X is equal to 1. That is one success. As I told you, there can be in different forums, that is three forums it can occur. A first success, second failure, third failure, or first failure, second failure, second success, third failure, or first failure, second failure, third success. So these are all independent events. So this can be written as probability of P into probability of Q into probability of Q plus probability of Q into probability of P into probability of Q plus probability of Q into probability of Q into probability of P. So that makes into 1 by 3 into 2 by 3 into 2 by 3 plus probability of a failure 2 by 3 probability of success 1 by 3 again probability of failure 2 by 3 plus probability of failure 2 by 3 failure 2 by 3 success 1 by 3. So when you simplify this, you get 4 by 27 from from this term, and 4 by 27 from the another term, 4 by 27 from the third term. So 4 by 27 plus 4 by 27 plus 4 by 27, that is 3 into 4 by 27 or 4 by 9. So probability of two successes, as I told you, this can come in three different ways. First two success, third failure. First success, second failure, third success. First failure, second success, third success. That is P of PPQ plus probability of PQP plus probability of QPP. So this can be written as probability of P into probability of P into probability of Q plus probability of P into probability of Q into probability of P plus probability of Q into probability of P into probability of P. So this is equal to probability of P 1 by 3, again 1 by 3, Q 2 by 3 plus probability of P 1 by 3 into probability of Q 2 by 3 plus probability of P 1 by 3 plus probability of Q 2 by 3 plus probability of P 1 by 3 and again probability of P 1 by 3. So this makes 2 by 27 plus from the second term 2 by 27 plus third term again 2 by 27. So this is 3 times 2 by 27 or 2 by 9. Probability of X is equal to 3. That means all the 3 success. There can be only one event of all successes P, P, P. So probability of P into probability of P into probability of P, that is probability of P into P into P, first success, second success, third success. So probability of P 1 by 3 into probability of P another 1 by 3 into probability of P 1 by 3. So this is 1 divided by 27. So thus the distribution is X takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, the corresponding probabilities P of no success 8 by 27, P of no success 8 by 27, P of 1 success, that is X is equal to 1, 4 by 9, 4 by 9, or 12 by 27, just to make the denominator same, 12 by 27, and 2 successes, 6 by 27, so this you can easily make out, 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 by 27, or 2 by 9, and 3, 1 by 27. So when you sum all this probability, it should become 1. So 12 into 8, 20, plus 6, 26, plus 1, 27. 27 by 27 is 1. That means the what we have derived, these probabilities is correct. Mean. So let us consider the next question, mean of X. That is E of X is again comes from the definition sigma x into px, so x is missing here, x is missing. Mean E of X is equal to X into PX. So this is equal to this into this plus this into this plus this into this plus this into this. So that makes 4 by 9 plus 4 by 9 plus 4 by 9. This term is 0. Okay. So that is equal to 8, 4 plus 4 plus 1, 9 by 9, that is equal to 1. So mean of the random variable capital X is 1. Now variance, the same old definition, sigma square variance is equal to sigma EX square minus E of X the whole square. So EX square, this is square into 1 plus this is square into 1 plus this square into 1, sorry, this square into 8 by 27 plus 1 square into 12 by 27 plus 2 square into 6 by 27 plus 3 square into 1 by 27. Okay, when you simplify, you get 4 by 9 from this term, 8 by 9 from this term, 9 by 27 from this term. So this is equal to 15 by 9 when you simplify. So 5 by 3 is the answer. So variance is EX square is 5 by 3 minus 1 square, that is our mean is 1, 1 square is equal to 2 by 3. Okay, problem number 6. 4 coins are tossed. What is the expectation of number of heads? 4 coins are tossed. So we have seen one in one problem, 3 coins are tossed. In defining the sample space, 3 coins are tossed. We got 8 sample points. So here 4 coins are tossed. What is the expectation of number of heads? Expectation of number of heads is mean, average of X. Expectation is the average, and X is the random variable, a discrete random variable, which takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 for a experiment when 4 coins are tossed. So similar to the previous problem, we have to first obtain the distribution of this of X. So let the random variable X denote the number of heads. Clearly, X can take the values 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, how do we get the probability of X is equal to 0, number of heads is equal to 0, is 1 by 6, 1 by 16. That means there should be 16 sample points. When we throw, when we toss 4 coins, what is the sample space? What is the sample? There must be 16 sample points. So how do we generate that? When X is 0, that means no heads, that means all tails, T, T, T. So if we roughly work out this, I will just show you the sample space for this. When 4 coins are tossed, the sample space is equal to all heads H, and one head, it can come like this, H T T T or T H T T T T H T T T H, then 2 heads can come in these forms H H T T H T H T H T T H TH 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 T H H T So one sample point should be HHTT is there, HTHT is there, HTTH is there, THHT, THHT is there, THTH is there, TTH, TTHH, then 3, that is 3 heads, H, 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 T, 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 H, H, then all T's. So just count this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So there are 16 sample points. Now from this sample space you can easily make out, so 16 is the exact number of cases. For example, P of x is equal to 0, that is no heads, there is only one favoring that particular event. So P of x is equal to 0 is 1 by 16. Similarly, P of 1 head, so there are 4 cases favoring 1, 2, 3, 4. So its probability P of x is equal to 1 is 1 by 4 by 16. So P of x is equal to 2. So 2 heads, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 cases in favor of this particular event. So P of 2 is 6 by 16. P of 3, 3 heads, there are 4 cases, 1, 2, 3, 4. So its probability P of x is equal to 3 is 4 by 16. Then P of x is equal to 4, that is, there is only one sample point favoring that particular event. So its probability is 1 by 16. So probability 1 by 16. So once again summarizing, when x is equal to 0, that is no heads, all tails, so P of x is equal to 1 by x is equal to 0 is 1 by 16. Probability of one success or one head is 4 by 16. Probability of two heads, 6 by 16. Probability of three heads, 4 by 16. Probability of four heads, 1 by 16. So when you sum this, 5 plus 6, 11 plus 5, 16, 16 by 16 is equal to 1. So expectation of x is E of x is sigma x into px, like we did in the previous problems. So if you take the product, summation of products, this is vertically. So 0 into 1 by 16 plus 1 into 4 by 16 plus 2 into 6 by 16 plus 3 into 4 by 16 plus 4 into 1 by 16, that makes up to 32 by 16, that is a thing but 2. So the expectation of number of heads when 4 coins are tossed is 2. So I will cancel out this worksheet. So these are the problems related to discrete random variable. So I am going to stop here. In my next class, I will take some problems on continuous random variable. Thank you.